Hello and welcome to WTNB Today. I'm your host, Wendy Benton. Thank you for joining me. I hope you're having a great day. I want to thank our sponsor, led-gear.com. If you have lighting or staging needs for parties or events, please visit their website, led-gear.com. Now let's take a quick look at our calendar of events sponsored by Southeast Crossroads Magazine. You can pick one up at area retailers in Bradley, Hamilton, McMinn, Meigs, Polk counties. They always have good articles and a complete calendar of events. On February 13th, Romance at Ruby Falls begins at 8:30. That is $59.95 per couple, and that goes through the 15th. Also on the 13th is Wild at Heart at the Chattanooga Zoo at 6 p.m. Members are $25, non-members $30. On February 14th, Valentine's Day, CASA will have their Red Shoe Gala at the Old Woolen Mill that begins at 6 p.m. Individuals are $50 and couples are $75. On February 15th, Jazzanooga at the Hunter Museum, that's a brunch beginning at 11 a.m. Members are $20 and non-members are $25. Also, an evening with Mark Lowry is February 17th. Please don't forget that. That benefits the Caring Place. If you want ticket information, go to eventbrite.com for more information on that. Also, February 21st is the Brouhaha at the Five Points Museum Center at Five Points, That's February 21st from 4 to 8. And that, I don't have ticket information for that. So a lot of things going on in the month of February, a lot of Valentine's events coming up. So you can add those to your calendar. Today I have Stan Evans with us and Laura Boyd. They are with the Sons of the American Revolution and Daughters of the American Revolution, and they're going to be with me in the studio after this message from Kyle Motors.
Hello, my name is Bill Kyle. I'm the owner of Kyle Motors, Cleveland, Tennessee. We're located at 802 20th Street Southeast. We're one block from a Blythe Bauer School, one block from a Cleveland Alden Highway. When you come in, don't forget to ask about the service contract. We have service contract on most all vehicles, and we invite you to come on over and take a look at these cars. For financing, we'll take care of your financing for you. Now, we have a lot of vehicles under $5,000. Ask about the vehicles. If you're looking for a car under $5,000, this is the place to go. Now, let's take a look at our top three vehicles for the month. We have a 2001 Chevrolet Tracker, automatic, air conditioning. The price is only $49.95. It's red in color, beautiful car. We have a 2001 Ford Ranger, automatic, golden color. Price is only $69.95. Come in and take a look at this Ford truck. We have a 99 Jeep Cherokee, six-cylinder, automatic, blue in color. Price is only $64.50. Come in and take a look at this Jeep. My name is Bill Kyle, owner of Kyle Motors. We invite you to come in and take a look at these vehicles. Tony Sism will show you a lot more cars that we have on the lot to choose from.
Hey, welcome to Kyle Motors. I'm Tony Sism, General Manager of Kyle Motors. Just come by and see us at 802 20th Street, Cleveland, Tennessee. Phone number 423-790-7100. Here we have a 1999 Chevrolet Tahoe, LT, red, new tires, brakes, leather, loaded up. Come drive it today, take it home today. Folks, right here we got a 2000 Oldsmobile Intrigue. Automatic, air, windows, locks, tilt, cruise. Just a real nice car for $39.95. 2000 model Ford Focus, just a real clean car. First good teenage car, first car. Come by and get it today, windows, locks, tilt, cruise, and air. Last but not least, we have a 2005 Dodge Caravan with only 96,000 miles. It seats seven people. with Stow and Go on the rear. Only 96,000 miles, 2005 model. Come by and take it home today.
My name is Bill Kyle, owner of Kyle Motors. We invite you to come in and take a look at these vehicles.
Welcome back to the show. I'm here with Stan Evans, who is the founder of the Colonel Benjamin Cleveland chapter of the Sons of the American Revolution, and Ms. Laura Boyd, who is the regent of the Ocoee chapter of the Daughters of the American Revolution. And they're going to talk more about the history of both of those organizations, because it's something to be very proud of, and I feel like our audience, our viewers, would be extremely interested in knowing more about what both of these organizations are and what they mean to our community. So welcome to the show.
Thank you for having us.
And what we usually do is just tell a little bit about who you are, your personal story, and where you came from, how you got to Cleveland, and I think our viewers enjoy that part of the show. So, Ms. Laura, if you would just share with us about your story.
I would be happy to. My name is Laura Boyd. I am a lifelong resident of East Tennessee. I was born in Knoxville and raised in the Chattanooga area, so I've lived all over the East Tennessee area. I went to school at Tennessee Tech, where I met my husband, and we were married 22 years ago. We have a lovely daughter who attends Cleveland High School, who's a senior, who is also very active in American history. She wants to go on and pursue a history degree and an education master's and teach. So that just warms my heart. Hopefully she'll end up at Tennessee Tech where I was. That will make me very happy. I got into the DAR kind of quite by accident. My great aunt was in the DAR. She was a member in an Oak Ridge chapter and started out in 1935. And when she passed away in the early 80s, I was young. And if she had told me about the DAR, I probably wouldn't have listened, wasn't interested. I was young. And when my grandmother passed away, which was her sister in 2002, I inherited a trunk of family genealogy. It had been my grandmother's hope chest, and it had four different patriot lines, all documented and all of the proof and all of the paperwork all neatly clipped together, and had letters and all kinds of interesting things. And when I inherited the trunk and started going through it, there was my aunt's, my great aunt's DAR certificate. And I was just so thrilled. I was like, because where we were living at the time was Eufaula, Alabama, and it was such a big deal down there. The DAR was such, in small town, deep south, USA, it was a big deal. Of course, it's a big deal here, but so I was very interested in joining. So I, of course, picked up the phone and joined the DAR down there. Went through the ranks of vice regent and served as the regent in Eufaula, Alabama. And then the phone rang one day, and it was Whirlpool calling, and so they moved us up here. My husband came up here to work for Whirlpool. So immediately, of course, I picked up the phone and researched the chapter here and found out that it was a good medium-sized chapter with lots of different age ladies, and I went to the chapter and felt like it would be a good fit, so I joined up here. I have been up here. I served as vice regent for a year, and then Marianne Dietrich, who was our regent, stepped down and thrust me into leadership, which was, that's the way to do it, is just to kind of jump into it and do it. And I've been the regent for this past year, and it's been such a wonderful experience and such a nice way to remember my patriot and the men that fought. He was at the Battle of Kings Mountain and was wounded and was taken away from his family. And luckily, he was one of the ones that was able to rejoin his family and settle in Upper East Tennessee. But it means a lot to me to recognize his passion and the sacrifices that he made. It keeps that legacy alive. So
it's so interesting, you know, the history of each person who's in the organizations. Stan, let's talk about your history.
Okay, my family were, my dad's, the Evans line was from around the Talladega, Anniston, Alabama area for about four generations. My mother was from Florida. Now, when she got pregnant with me, guess what? We moved from Alabama down to Florida where her family was. I was born. A few weeks later, we're back in Alabama. And then a year and a half later, the same thing happened to my sister. She was born in Florida, but we live mostly in Alabama. So anyway, my mother died during the war, 1943. And then, make a long story short, we bounced between aunts, uncles, whatever. And then my grandmother on my father's side, she was living in Florida then. She took us in, became our guardian, adopted us, you might say, and raised us. Well, first employment I had was, I was in the Army National Guard initially, and I went on into the U.S. Navy, the aviation portion of it, in 1957, and I did 4.5 years with them, got out, and being aviation, I came back to that area, West Palm Beach area, and I worked for 3 years with Pratt Whitney Aircraft Corporation. And we were building a big monstrous jet engine, and nobody knew what it was going into. Well, it ended up going into the SR-71, fastest plane in the world. Well, I ended up in 1964 going back into the service, and I stayed for 20, so I'm a career military man. In the meantime, I worked and got my bachelor's degree, and May of 1980, I got my master's degree that month. I got a job with another aerospace company, May of 80, and I got retired out of the military, all in that 1 month.
Wow.
So then I worked with a couple other aviation aerospace type companies. The one was Veda. It was up in Patuxent River, Maryland area. That's where we rang out all the new aircraft for the Navy, Marine Corps, you know. And from there, I went down to Ocala, Florida. That's what took me down there with Martin Marietta. And they were building those, what they call smart bullets, those missiles, guided projectiles, missiles. And I was with them 11 years. And people said, how did you get to Cleveland? I said, well, the good Lord, I guess, I had a pull to come to this part of the country again, you know, like coming back home. And when we got here, people said, well, who do you know here? I said, well, I know the realtor lady that showed us a house and the contractor that built the house. But it feels more like home here than anywhere we've been together, really. So before, as far as the SAR, Sons of the American Revolution, I got exposed to that in Ocala, Florida, and probably, let's see, I joined in February. This is my anniversary month, 27 years ago, February 1988. And within a year, I was a chapter president down there. Went on up through the ranks with the state. I was state president in 1994. And at that time, the Florida Society, SAR, was the third largest in the country. So that was a challenge running all that group. But then I went on up through several national positions. I was a trustee for the Florida Society the next year, 1995. 96 was a big year. I was made the Vice President General of the South Atlantic District, which includes North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, and Florida. Those state presidents reported to me. I reported to the President General at National. So that was your general officer at that point. I've chaired several, in fact, about 8 years I've been the chairman of some national committee. We had Patriots Index. I'd been with the Veterans Committee for many years. And about 3 years ago, I took on a job nobody else wanted. They run from it. It's a genealogy committee, chairman of it. And I think I ran a talk ship, as they say in the Navy, and we accomplished everything that was put before us. But As far as forming new chapters, okay, that's why I'm here. I'm the founder of the Colonel Benjamin Cleveland chapter. But before that, in Florida, I had put together four chapters down there. They're all still doing fine. This is the fifth one. And I've got one up in Athens we did later. So in 2003, I had the idea that this would be a gold mine area for recruiting people for DAR, SAR. So I talked to the region at that time. Momquist, what was her name? Helen Momquist, that's who it is. And I said, how long has the DAR been in Cleveland, Tennessee? She says, since December the 9th, 1909. I said, my gosh, we're going to have to get something for the Suns before y'all have your centennial. Well, it turned out they had their centennial in 2009, and our chapter was a color guard, you know, worked with them on that.
You are so instrumental on so many levels, Stan. It's amazing what all you've been involved with and how big that these organizations are across the country. Mm-hmm. Hold that thought.
Sure.
We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, go into the history of the DAR, exactly what it is, and how you can be a part of it if you're able to be a part of it, because there's some restrictions on some things, or you have to have the lineage there. So we'll be right back after this message.
Have you heard about the new WTNB deals around town? No? Well, then let me tell you all about it. Deals Around Town airs right here on WTNB Monday evenings at 7 p.m. I watch it because it features great local restaurants from right here in our area. And better yet, I can get 25, 50, even 75% off on these places when I just call in and buy a gift certificate. That's right, I just call in during the show and pick from dozens of deals. Rumor has it that WTNB Deals Around Town is growing and growing, so much so that they may be adding another night of savings. I've even heard that they will soon add even more places, and not just restaurants. We're talking kids' fun, massages, who knows what will turn up. Remember, it's Monday evenings at 7 p.m. only on WTNB.
I'm Dr. Ricky Hutchison with Tennessee Valley Bone and Joint. Our hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 or 6. We run a free sports medicine clinic on Saturdays. We want people to know that Tennessee Valley Bone and Joint is here for them because you're part of our family.
Are you ready for Valentine's Day? ISBO Floral Gallery has you covered. Mention you saw this ad on WTNB and receive free delivery in Cleveland between now and Valentine's Day. ISBO Floral Gallery, the only florist you'll ever need.
The Cleveland Housing Authority's mission is to provide affordable, safe, and sanitary housing opportunities to low-end and moderate-income families. Flexible monthly rental options are available, so contact us today to see if you qualify for premier housing from the Cleveland Housing Authority. Visit www.clevelandhousingauthority.com or call us 423-479-9659.
For over 25 years, Ed Jacobs & Associates has been treating each of our clients like business partners. Finding the right insurance for your employees shouldn't be that complicated or expensive. Receiving quality financial advice for you and your business should be even easier. We treat each client with respect and integrity and handle your situation as if it was our own. Call me today for your own free consultation.
Welcome back. I'm here with Laura Boyd and Stan Evans talking about two very historical organizations that have been around since the late 1800s, the Daughters of the American Revolution and the Sons of the American Revolution. Laura, how is this organization, how has it grown over the years? Is it just in our area, the Southeast, or is it bigger than that?
Well, the DAR started in Washington, D.C. in 1890 as a result of organizations like the Sons of the American Revolution starting the year before that were only for men. So the women in D.C. decided that the women needed an organization where they could be patriotic and preserve history and support education as well as the men do. So the DAR was born in 1890. It started out with four women and it has grown. Over the last 125 years there have been 925,000 women that have been in the DAR. Currently we have 177,000 current members. We have over 3,000 chapters across the USA and in some international spots like Mexico and Europe. We have troops overseas that are members of the DAR and have their own chapters where they're located overseas. So it's a huge organization that of course supports historic preservation, education, and patriotism amongst women.
Well, and last week you had your awards ceremony at the Cleveland Public Library, mm-hmm. and Stan and some of the Sons of the American Revolution were in attendance there, and we've got a clip to show from that awards ceremony. Let's take a look at that right now. And we are at the Daughters of the American Revolution Awards Ceremony, and he actually helped found the Sons of the American Revolution. So I want Stan to tell us a little bit of the history of his organization.
Okay, thank you very much. As she said, I'm Stan Evans, and back in 2003, the nearest Sons of the American Revolution chapter was in Chattanooga, and I'd belonged to it once we moved back to Tennessee. So I said, well, let me go talk to the DAR ladies and see how long they've been around in Cleveland. So I talked to the regent that year, and she said, well, we've been here since December the 9th, 1909. I said, well, my gosh, I'm going to have to get something going for the Sons before y'all have your centennial. Well, what's ironic is when they had the centennial in 2009, we were the color guard for the meeting. So anyway, we started with about 29 people, and about 5 years ago, we grew to where we were the largest chapter in the Tennessee Society. And right now, we finished the year with 196 members. So we've outbeat all the big boys, Nashville, Chattanooga, Memphis, all of them. So, proud to be here today to help these ladies out in their youth awards presentation.
we have the privilege of nominating a senior each year who represents good citizenship in our school and in our community. And so we chose Neely Benton because of her excellent leadership on our campus and her involvement in the community. She has had a lot of leadership positions. She's active in every aspect of our school. But even more than that, she shows a lot of character and integrity. She's loving and caring towards other students, and we thought she was a great example of a good citizen. So
I'm just honored by the award and being nominated, and that the Daughters of the American Revolution put on this and recognize seniors from each of the schools. And I'm honored by our faculty and staff that nominated me for this, and it's just real, it's an honor, and I'm excited about it.
Excellent. So what are you guys planning to do after this? Any celebration?
Eat lunch.
Cool.
That's a great clip, and Stan did a wonderful job explaining some of the things about the history of the Colonel Benjamin Cleveland chapter here and how it's grown to 196 members. Stan, tell the viewers too about your different uniforms that you wear.
Okay, you'll see in the clip there, we had the Continental Line uniform. That would have been like the regular Army today. The one I have was the blue. You've heard of the red coats, we have the blue coats. We have the militia. Now Sam Allen, he had a frontiersman militia uniform on. Our state president, Claude Hardison, he had a country planter's outfit. He would have had some big plantation and would still have been a patriot. Okay, basically each militiaman, you would have 10 different groups, you'd have 10 different militia or outfits there. But basically, they all fought for the common cause, creating our country, what is now the United States of America, from 13 disorganized little countries there, and gained our freedom from Great Britain, who was the bad guy at that time.
Yes, okay. That's it in a nutshell. And you all do a wonderful job representing those great Americans who fought back in that war. Laura, what about the awards that you all do give out? The DAR, and I know the SAR, I'm sure, mm-hmm. gives awards as well. We just saw the clip from your award ceremony.
We give out 6 American History Awards to 6 middle school age children here in Cleveland-Bradley County, and we also give out 6 Good Citizenship Awards to high school age children here in Bradley County, and that's an annual event that we do. Another award that we give regularly in May is for a junior ROTC person from Bradley County High School. Since they have the Bradley County Junior ROTC, we give a bronze award to a student that exemplifies what we stand for, plus grades and military preparation.
And Stan, do you all do the same awards, leadership
we
awards?
We have a multitude of awards. At the community level, we have awards. You've probably seen over the years, we honor the police department. We give awards to the Bradley County Sheriff's Department, Cleveland Police Department, and that's usually in May. Later on, we'll have the EMS, Emergency Medical Service people. We give them one a year. Matter of fact, when that award came out, we have the distinction here in Cleveland, Tennessee, the Colonel Benjamin Cleveland chapter, as giving the very first Emergency Medical Service Award in the country here in Cleveland. And we also give the firemen, they have the Fire Safety Commendation Medals, and that's all community. We have many, many others. With the youth, we have the Junior ROTC, there's Oration Contest, there's Essay Contest, it just goes on and on. This year we have, in Tennessee, we've got the first entry in a History Teacher Contest, and hopefully that we can take that lady and take her up to national, and maybe we'll win a national.
Award. That's wonderful.
But we have so many different awards. We honor the DAR. We have special awards for them. Like you mentioned, the Good Citizenship Awards. We have bronze. We have the silver. Usually the silver is at a level like we honored a past governor of Tennessee maybe 3 or 4 years ago with that. On up at the gold Good Citizenship, past President Reagan, Ronald Reagan, received that one. So you see, that's at a higher level. But there's all sorts of other little awards that are in between, really.
And speak real briefly, Laura, how you can become a member, because I alluded to the fact that you had to have special lineage to be a part of one of these organizations, because
right.
not just anybody can join.
Right. Any woman that is 18 years of age or older that can prove lineage to either somebody that fought in the American Revolution or aided in the cause of American independence. So, for instance, my patriot, one of my patriots actually fought at Kings Mountain, and another one delivered the prayer before they fought. He didn't actually fight, but he delivered the prayer, so he is recognized as a patriot as well. And if you have questions, you can email me at my email address. You can go on online, basically, at www.dar.org, or you can go, and there's a link that where you can click on the Tennessee site, or the Tennessee has a webpage as well, and then you can come on down to the Ocoee chapter site, and if you click on all that, of course, it's going to come to me.
Okay, and we have both of your email addresses on
Great.
The screen for people who are interested. They could just contact you with questions.
Mm-hmm. That would be great.
Or go to the main website.
Right, the main websites.
And does the SAR also have the same SAR.org?
Well, we have a junior membership, which starts at, in fact, we've had them 1 month old up to 18. Now, at 18, they become a regular member. Now we have one that just turned 18 this within the past month, Hunter McLean. Tommy McLean used to be a captain on the police force. That's his grandson. Mm-hmm. And we've watched Hunter grow, and now he's over at Lee University.
Wow.
By the way, he's going to be an Episcopal priest.
Oh my goodness.
But he comes to all of our graveside dedications and all the events like that. But We're kind of like, our membership is kind of like the U.S. Marine Corps. We're always looking for a few good men.
That is great. Well, it's been a delight to talk to both of you today. And I think our audience has learned a little bit more about what your chapters do here in our community and the award ceremony. That was some really nice footage from that last week. My daughter was one of the recipients, so it was an honor for me to be there also, and to meet you you all and your the friends and other members of your organization. So hopefully you have learned a lot about the Daughters of the American Revolution and Sons of the American Revolution. And I want to remind you not to forget about the WTNB TV Valentine's Day giveaway that will be drawn on February 11th. Please go to our Facebook page, WTNB TV, for more information. And that is sponsored by Isbell Floral Gallery, Blissful Berries, and Outback Steakhouse. So that's a great Valentine's evening for you and someone special. So please visit our Facebook page, and we will see you next time on WTNB Today.